This is the Edifier Stack Spirit S10, which looks like it has the perfect recipe to be a game-changing pair of wireless earbuds since it has planar magnetic drivers and has active noise cancellation as well. So is this a game changer or is Edifier trying too hard to impress? Now, if you watch our previous Stack Spirit S5 video, you'll kind of know what to expect because the unboxing experience here is very similar. Now, the first thing you'll see is the outer box sleeve with the visuals of the earbuds in the middle. Then there's the supported audio codecs here at the top right and the other features at the bottom left. For some reason, the full name of the earbuds are only at the back of the box. Not sure why it is like this, but hey, it is what it is. And you can see a lot more of the earbuds features at the back. Now, sliding the outer box off reveals a box design that is exactly the same style as the S3 and the S5 with the Stack Spirit all around it, which reminds me of the binary text from the Matrix. Then opening the box, you'll see a square envelope which has the user manual and the safety guide and basically your usual documentations. Underneath are the earbuds themselves in a case, and god damn, that is a lot of ear tips, as you get a total of 7 sets of different size ear tips that are color coded to match their size. I do not know about you, but I have never seen anything like this because Edifier is looking to be very committed to give everyone the ultimate experience here, and if you still can't get this to fit in your ears, I don't know what to say. And finally, you'll find the accessory pouch, and also included is a short USB-A to USB-C cable. Now let's start with the charging case first. Now it is a fully plastic case that looks very similar to a lot of the other Edifier wireless earbud cases. Now the case has a gunmetal color which I like and has a matte finish, and as you all know, I always prefer something like this because there are less chances for it leaving any ugly fingerprints on. And you can also see the Stack logo at the top of the case. But what's weird is that although it has a matte finish, I found the case to be a little slippery and hard to open one-handed. So if you're going to open this in a public area, like for example in a train or a bus, do be extra careful. Now the case has just one button on the inside where you can use it to either pair the earbuds to a device or just reset the earbuds altogether. However, if it's the first time, the earbuds will immediately be on the pairing mode thanks to Google Fast Pair. Next, there is a light indicator in front, and at the back you'll find the USB-C charging port. Then taking a look at the earbuds inside, the first thing that I notice is that this is quite big and thick.
That's what she said!
Now, the reason why they are a lot bigger than the normal wireless earbuds is because they need to fit the large planar magnetic drivers inside. And yes, I'll talk more about that later in this video. And another thing that makes this different from other earbuds is the fact that it comes with a pressure-sensitive touchpad placed along the sides of the stems compared to the sensors being on top like many others. Then the earbuds also has sensors inside, so this is for the wear detection where it pauses the music when you take them off your ears and resumes the music or media when you put them back on. Now, just like the bigger brother, the S5, this earbuds can be connected to the new Edifier Connect app, not to be confused with the Edifier Connect app previously. Now, through the app's main page, you get access to extra features that you can use to customize your listening experience. But unlike the S3 or the S5, this comes with active noise cancellation. Now you can play around with the noise cancellation controls, which can be set to high or medium. And if you plan to use this outside for a run, there's also the ambient mode that lets you hear the outside noise, so you can be very well aware of your surroundings when listening to music when you're outdoors. Now, Edifier has also included a wind reduction mode that minimizes noise in a windy environment. And if you're not a fan of any kind of a noise cancellation, you can choose to turn it off altogether. Then the app also has 3 default sound effects: original, dynamic, and electrostatic, each with its very unique sound profiles. Now, if neither of this is to your liking, you can always customize the EQ settings to suit your style. Now, for all you mobile gamers out there, don't worry because there's also a game mode setting that you can use for low latency audio performance when you play games. And you can access a lot more of the customization options in the app when you hit the gear icon at the top right of the screen. And here you can set the touch control settings and even control the press sensitivity as well. Now you also have the access to the audio codec settings and changing the sample rates of LDAC and LHDC codecs, and the multi-point connection can also be turned on through the app over here as well, where this allows you to connect to multiple devices at once. And of course, this is a very useful feature, especially if you use many devices at home or at work. However, because of limitations of a Bluetooth connection, using this feature will disable LDAC and LHDC functions, but you can turn the settings back on later if you really need to. Now, battery life on these earbuds are pretty good. It lasted me about 4 hours on a single charge with noise cancellation turned on, and slightly more than 6 hours with noise cancellation turned off. And the earbuds took about an hour to fully recharge. Now, in case you're wondering, there are no wireless charging on this, so the only way for you to charge the earbuds is through the wired charging option. So the biggest feature of this earbuds is the fact that this earbuds are the very first and only earbuds right now to come with planar magnetic drivers, a signature feature for all Stack Spirit audio products so far. Now, without going too deep into the science of it all, basically they have shrunk the planar magnetic drivers of the S5 to become a tiny 12mm modularized planar magnetic drivers, which are capable of delivering sound that is much better and cleaner than normal drivers. Now, the earbuds also comes with the same Qualcomm chip as the S5, where this chip not only allows for Bluetooth 5.4 support, but also supports the Snapdragon Sound Suite of audio codecs, where this includes LDAC, LHDC, and Qualcomm's aptX HD, aptX Adaptive, and aptX Lossless audio codecs. And speaking of support, you can also support us and this video by giving this video a thumbs up and comment down below what you guys think of this particular earbuds, and a subscription to the channel will be very lovely too. Thank you very much in advance. Now, by default, this earbuds produce a very clean sound that is suitable for any type of music genre. The bass is punchy and powerful without drowning everything else, and the overall sound performance is quite warm. Now, of course, you can customize the sound performance the way you like, and personally for me, I use the dynamic settings as I prefer the slightly punchier bass when I was listening to music. Then as for the game mode, it works quite well, and I use it a lot during COD Mobile, and I couldn't detect any major lags even during intense matches. So if you like to game a lot and listen to music a lot, then you'll be quite satisfied with this. Now, watching movies and videos are also quite a hugely enjoyable experience. The dialogue is nice and crisp, and because of the great bass, action scenes are really nice to watch. We can almost hear the impact of the punches and the kicks in each scene. But speaking of punches, have you ever felt like a fist going into your ears? Or want to feel a fist go inside your ears?
What do you mean by that?
Now, I know this is a very weird question, but that is exactly how I felt when I turned the noise cancellation on this earbuds. Now, I am used to other noise cancellation earbuds before, but I never experienced such discomfort like this, because the pressure that these earbuds produce when the noise cancellation is turned on was very intense and quite uncomfortable, that it actually made me feel like I just had to turn it off. Now, at first, I just thought it was my music app, but it also happened when I was watching Netflix or even YouTube. So I guess here's where I feel that planar magnetic drivers are not really meant to have ANC, and that's why the headphones does not usually have them. Now, maybe it's just me, but if you have these earbuds and watching this video, do let me know if you're having the same experience in the comment section below. But here is a sound test using our binaural microphones to record these earbuds. So put on your best headphones or your earbuds to get the best audio experience.
But I know it's better to surrender my status. I order you to stand down and return to port immediately. I repeat, CT-05, return to port.
Now, as for the microphones, this earbuds comes with a total of 6 built-in mics with 3 mics on each side. Together with Qualcomm's aptX voice technology, Edifier says that the earbuds are capable of clear calls even in noisy environments. And of course, I tested out myself, and so far the mics perform pretty well. And based on the feedback that I got from some people that I made a call with, my voice was clear most of the time, but it did start to drown out just a bit when I was in a more noisy environment. But here is another sound test.
Alright, so I'm at home editing this video. There's a ceiling fan on top, so this is a microphone test. Test 1, 2, test 1, 2, test 1, 2. Now, speaking of being at home, one annoying thing as of late is that when I open up my balcony, it's super noisy. So this is a microphone test in an extremely noisy environment. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Test 1, 2.
Now, if you like what you're watching and would like to have a written version of this whole review, there is one at our website at www.adamlobo.tv. Links will be down below, and we have some daily tech news over there too. Okay. So, in conclusion, I feel that these earbuds are a bit of a mixed bag. They aren't a huge slam dunk as they should be, but on one hand, these earbuds have fantastic sound quality, great features, and good app integration. On the other hand, the noise cancellation on this is quite uncomfortable and can be quite distracting and might be a deal breaker for some people. Then, as for the price, as of the recording of this video, it is priced at 1,999 ringgit. But do check out all the links down below for the updated price of these earbuds.